A wonderful morning to one and all present there. How are you all? I hope you all are fit, fine, healthy. You're staying home, you're staying safe. As we are at the mid of periodic test 3. So now we have to, now the lesson which we are going to undertake is lesson number 8 from your textbook Beehive of class 9th, unit 8, Reach for the Top. So this story has two parts. Okay, part 1 is regarding Santosh Yadav, and second part, okay, we have two phrases in the lesson. So, okay, this unit has two biological pieces, biographical pieces that depict persistent endeavors to reach the top. Part 2 of this unit is taken from a newspaper. The language is very current and idiomatic, and exercise of matching words and phrases to their meanings have been given as a pre-reading activity. So here, as you can see, in the pre-reading activity, think for a while and make a list of 3 to 5 persons you idolize or admire very much for their achievements. Your idols may be from any sphere of life: sports, medicine, media, or art and culture. So dear students, here we all have role models, correct? We all have idols. Now who are called idols? Whom we follow, who are very ideal, okay? Whom their life we want to imitate, we want to follow their footsteps, because they have achieved something and they have certain qualities which we want to adapt in our life. So that is called idols. So we want to idolize. So you have to list 3 to 5 persons in your mind, or you can even write it that you admire them for what. You have to write it that also. It can be of any field. It can also be your mother or your father whom you idolize. It can even be your friend, or it can even be a great personality. Okay, a person from sports. For example, I idealize Marie Kondo, as she has achieved great heights and she has also helped in removing the gender inequality in the society. Same way, if you take medicine, media, or art and culture, whatsoever you take, there must be one idol. You must be idolizing someone. So list out 3 to 5 names. Okay, so here we will talk about a woman, a lady whose name is Santosh Yadav. Okay, the only woman in the world who has scaled Mount Everest twice, was born in a society where the birth of a son was regarded as a blessing. So now, she was born and brought up in such a society where people used to wish for only a boy child, okay, not a girl child. What they want, only a boy child, so that she was born in such a society, okay, where her birth did not give any happiness to the society and maybe even to the parents. Let us see. And a daughter, though not considered a curse, was not generally welcome. Okay, the girls were not considered as a curse, but also they were not generally welcome. That yes, if we want, they don't become that happy as they are happy with a boy child. When her mother was expecting Santosh, a traveling holy man giving her his blessing assumed that she wanted a son. Okay, but to everyone's surprise, the unborn child's grandmother, who was standing close by, told him that they did not want a son. The holy man was also surprised. Nevertheless, he gave the requested blessing, and as destiny would have it, the blessing seemed to work. Santosh was born to the 6th child in a family with 5 sons, a sister, to 5 brothers. She was born in the small village of Joniawas of Rewari district in Haryana. Okay, so you can underline these lines that she was born in a small village of Joniawas of Rewari district in Haryana. She was born in Haryana. And now thing we're going to talk about her is the first thing that at that time in her society everyone wished for a male child. They did not want a female child, that is, they did not want a girl child. And at that time there was a holy man. Okay, he was visiting their place, he was traveling nearby, and he thought that the mother of this Santosh, when she was expecting, when she was pregnant with Santosh, a holy man traveling from there, he gave her blessing that you will have a boy child, okay, you will have a son. But to everyone's surprise, the unborn child's grandmother, okay, the grandmother always wished, she stood, she was standing close by, and she said that we do not want a son, but we want a daughter. So he was also, the holy man was also surprised with the this statement, that in a society where everyone is wishing for a son, this lady is asking for a daughter. But so he just gave a blessing to them, and the blessing seemed to work. And Santosh was born, the sixth child. Okay, there were already five sons, and now the sixth one is Santosh, and Santosh is a sister to five brothers. Okay, so she was born in the Haryana. Second paragraph is on the page number 100. The girl was given the name Santosh, which means contentment, satisfaction. But Santosh was not always content with her place in a traditional way of life. As you as we say that whatever the name is there, such qualities is inbuilt in the person's personality. But here Santosh means contentment, but Santosh was not content with her traditional way of life. Whatever was a routine, monotonous life she was living, she was not contented with that. She wanted something more. She began giving life on her own terms from the start. Where other girls wore traditional Indian dresses, Santosh preferred shorts. Looking back, she says now, from the very beginning, I was quite determined that if I chose a correct and rational path, the others around me had to change, not me. Now she says that when the people around her used to wear traditional Indian dresses, at that time she used to wear shorts, and she never felt shamed on it. Why? Because she thought that if I choose a correct path, if I'm not wrong, if I am rational, if I choose a correct and rational path, then the people around me has to change, not me. That is what she thought. Paragraph number 3. Santosh's parents were affluent landowners who could afford to send their children to the best schools, even to the country's capital, New Delhi, which was quite close by. But in line with the prevailing custom in the family, Santosh had to make do with the local village school. So she decided to fight the system in her own quiet way when the right moment arrived. And the right moment came when she turned 16. At 16, most of the girls in her village used to get married. Santosh was also under pressure from her parents to do the same. So now when we talk about the financial background of the Santosh, they were affluent, they were landowners. The family, the Santosh parents were landowners. So if they wish, they could even send her to the any part or to the best school of the whole country. Even they can send to the New Delhi, that is country's capital, correct? India's capital is Delhi. So they were so affluent, means they were so well-to-do. But because of the society and because of the customs prevailing in the family, Santosh had to make do with the local village school. Okay, she wanted to study outside. She wanted to study in the best schools. She did not want to study in Haryana in the village school. But because of this culture around them, because of this society's pressure, she was forced to study in the local village school. So she decided to fight this system on her own, that if a girl child want to go outside the city for studies, they are not going to do something bad. Okay, this kind of ideology she needed to change. And but she wanted the right movement. When she was very young, it cannot be changed by her. So she decided to live the life on her own, but she waited for the right moment. So dear students, if you think you are correct, if you think you are rational, okay, you are making rational choice, then there is a right time for everything. It is not that you need to shout, you need to jump on your request, you need to force your parents to do something. No, what she did was she waited for a right moment. So you also, if you think you are correct in a path, or if you think you are rational, you are making a rational choice, then you need to stand on your own and wait for the right moment. So at the age of 16, that was a right moment. At 16, most of the girls in her village used to get married. And she was also asked to get married because of the family pressure. But she thought, no, I want to make up my career. Paragraph number 4, a marriage as early as that was the last thing on her mind. She threatened her parents that she would never marry if she did not get a proper education. She left home and got herself enrolled in the school in Delhi. When her parents refused to pay for her education, she politely informed them of her plans to earn money by working part-time to pay her school fees. Her parents then agreed to pay for her education. So now, dear students, in her mind, she never thought of the marriage at the age of 16. Marriage would be the last, she would thought, but the last thing in her mind to come, last thing on her mind to accomplish. She threatened her parents that if you won't give me a proper education, I won't marry at all. So if you want me to marry, you need to give me proper education, and this proper education I won't get in this village. I will get outside the city, that is in the Delhi, in the school. Though they were affluent, but they did not allow her to go there, and they forced her that if you will go there, we are not going to pay off the fees for your school. You have to do it on your own. So she politely, politely informed them of her plans. She did not argue with them that, okay, you don't want to give me money, that's okay, I'll do it on my own. No, she politely informed her plans that this is my dream and this is what I want to do. I want to take proper education in New Delhi, and if you are not going to pay the money, then it's okay, I will be earning it by my own. I will work part-time to pay the school fees. So on her request, on her politeness, her parents agreed to pay for her education. Fifth paragraph. Wishing always to study a bit more, and with her father slowly getting used to her urge for more education, Santosh passed the high school examinations and went to Jaipur. She joined Maharani College and got a room in Kasturba Hostel. Santosh remembers Kasturba Hostels faced the Aravali Hills. I used to watch villagers from my room, going up the hill and suddenly vanishing after a while. One day, I decided to check it out myself. I found nobody except a few mountaineers. I asked if I could join them. To my pleasant surprise, they answered in the affirmative. That means they said yes, and motivated me to take to climbing. So dear students, what happened now? On her request, her parents agreed to give her the fees for the education, correct? And then she joined the school, and then she completed her wishing always to study a bit more. That means she was so enthusiastic in studies that if you give her one lesson, she would study 1.5 lessons. Okay, if you are giving you homework, as a teacher, if we are giving you homework, what would you do? You just bug around here and there. Okay, you will just think that, okay, baad mein kar lungi. But here, she had an urge to study a bit more. Okay, that burning desire she had, okay, in herself, that yes, I want to do it. So she was always one step ahead what was required. So her this desire, her this willingness made her father convinced for this to let her go out of the city and study there. She successfully completed her high school examinations and now she went to Jaipur for further studies. She joined Maharani College and in Kasturba hostel she got a room there. And she still remember that Kasturba's hostel faced the Aravali Hills. So these are one kind of hills that you can see in the picture. If you open up page number 101, you will find the picture. This is a picture. This is Aravali Hill. I used to watch villagers from my room that they were going up to the hill and suddenly they vanished, disappeared. One day I decided to check it out that I found nobody except a few mountaineers. There were the villagers used to climb to go up the hill, but this time she decided to just personally visit there. When she went there, she found nobody except few mountaineers. Now who are called mountaineers who climb the mountains with the professional skills. So she met few mountaineers and she asked that if she could join them. She wanted to climb the mountain. To her pleasant surprise, they answered in an affirmative, yes, they positively answered that yes. And they even motivated her to take to climbing, that yes, you can come along with us, okay, we'll teach you what to do. Paragraph number 6. Then there was no looking back for this determined young girl. She saved money and enrolled in a course at Uttarkashi's Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. She was so fascinated with this thought about mountaineering that she joined an institution. Okay, that was Uttarkashi's Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. My college semester in Jaipur was to end in April, but it ended on the 9th of May, and I was supposed to be in Uttarkashi on the 12th first. So I did not go back home. Instead, I headed straight for the training. I had to write a letter of apology to my father, without whose permission I had got myself enrolled in Uttarkashi. So this should not be done because in the vacation, her plans was to meet her parents, okay, to meet her father. But she was so much motivated with this mountaineering stuff that she enrolled herself in the mountaineering in the Uttarkashi without the consent, without the permission of her father. She also wrote an apology letter that I'm not going to come in this vacation because I have joined this institution of training for the mountaineering. Thereafter, Santosh went on an expedition every year. Her climbing skills matured rapidly also. So every year she used to get herself trained, enrolled in the same. Every year she went on an expedition and her climbing skills matured very rapidly, very fastly. Also, she developed a remarkable resistance to cold and the altitude. Okay, your skin, your body is habituated to survive in the particular temperature. Okay, and in cold environment you cannot feel good, you cannot stay fit. But she developed that resistance, that yes, her body adapted it to survive in a cold and in a very altitude, heighted place. Okay, on altitude and in cold area she can also survive there very nicely. So equipped with an iron will, physical endurance and an amazing mental toughness, she proved herself repeatedly the culmination of her hard work and sincerity came in 1992. Just 4 years after she had shyly asked the Aravali mountaineers if she could join them. Okay, from the first day in a hostel room, when she went there to meet the personally the villagers, just after four years training, she was successful. So at barely 20 years of age, Santosh Yadav scaled Mount Everest, becoming the youngest woman in the world to achieve the feat. If her climbing skills, physical fitness and mental strength impressed her seniors, her concern for others and desire to work together with them found her a special place in the hearts of the fellow climbers. Okay, so you can see in the picture that iron will means very strong will, as iron cannot be melted very easily. It needs a high temperature. In the same way, she was considered as iron will. Physical endurance and mental toughness characterized Santosh Yadav. So her physical endurance and her mental toughness characterize Santosh Yadav. So these three qualities we should learn, we should also idolize from the Santosh Yadav, that we should be mentally tough, physically we should be physically also strong, and we should have iron will. So this is what we will study for today. We'll continue the rest of the lesson. We'll complete the rest of the lesson in our next class. Okay, we have only 3 paragraphs left. We'll complete it today only. Okay. Paragraph number 8. During the 1992 Everest mission, Santosh Yadav provided special care to a climber who lay dying at the South Pole. College, she was unfortunately unsuccessful in saving him. So during 1992 Everest mission, Santosh Yadav provided special care to a climber who lay dying at the South Pole. She was unfortunately unsuccessful in saving him. She couldn't save him. However, she managed to save another climber. Mohan Singh, his name was, who would have met with the same fate had she not shared her oxygen with him. Okay, if she would have not shared her oxygen with him, he would have not been survived. Paragraph number 9. Within 12 months, Santosh found herself a member of an Indo-Nepalese women's expedition that invited her to join them. She then scaled the Everest a second time, thus setting a record as the only woman to have scaled the Everest twice and securing for herself and India a unique place in the annals of mountaineering. In recognition of her achievements, the Indian government bestowed upon her one of the nation's top honors, the Padma Shri. Okay, so within 12 months she again found herself as a member of Indo-Nepalese women's expedition that invited her to kindly join with us. Then scaled the Everest a second time, and she was succeeded in that, and she became the only woman to have scaled the Everest twice and securing for herself and India a unique place in the annals of mountaineering. She became very famous in the field of mountaineering, and in recognition of her achievements, the Indian government gifted her nation's top honors, that is the Padma Shri. Describing her feelings when she was literally on the top of the world, and how she was feeling and how she was motivated to reach at that place, Santosh had said, "It took some time for the enormity of the moment to sink in. Then I unfurled the Indian tricolor and held it up high on the roof of the world. The feeling is indescribable. The Indian flag was flying on the top of the world. It was truly a spiritual moment. I felt proud as an Indian. Also, a fervent environmentalist, Santosh collected and brought down 500 kilograms of garbage from the Himalayas. Fervent means having strong and sincere feelings regarding, she had a strong and sincere feeling towards the environment. She was a dedicated person towards the environment. So she also brought up 500 kilograms of the garbage from the Himalayas. When she went there, she reached the top, she also cleaned that place. She also brought garbage from the Himalayas. So this is a wonderful story and a very inspirational story of Santosh Yadav. So this is the first part of the story. Second part of the story is about Maria Sharapova. So kindly read that story also. We will continue it in our next video. The PDF of this lesson will be sent to you in the group. So kindly write it, write the word meanings and write down the question answers in your notebook. First, you write down the word meanings in your notebook. When you will be sent PDF of this, kindly complete your notebooks too.